Subscribe to the Archivist 42 channel for gaming top 5s, reviews, and more. Hi people, it's Archivist here, coming at you with yet another top 5. Among all the great sandbox franchises out there, one stands tall above the rest. The Grand Theft Auto series has long been the measure of any open world, and you can see why considering the unwavering quality of the games. Starting off in the classic top-down perspective, GTA has evolved immensely since its humble beginnings. So in today's list, I'll be going through my top 5 Grand Theft Auto games. Enjoy.
Number 5.
Back in the early 2000s and late 90s, a lot of game franchises were making that difficult transition to 3D. Some made the jump very well, whereas others were not so successful. Grand Theft Auto 3 for the PlayStation 2 fell into the former category. Amongst the cloud of controversy that surrounded GTA 3, there was an excellent game to be found. Never before had an open world been so fully realised. The concept of being able to go wherever you wanted and do anything you wanted resonated well with a lot of gamers. A quality title for sure, and it did well to establish a solid foundation for future games.
Number 4.
Grand Theft Auto 4 decided to go in a slightly different direction to its more zany predecessors. The story of Niko Bellic was far more gritty than that of past protagonists, and this shift in tone was met with mixed reactions. Some loved this more realistic take on the GTA series, whereas others thought it had lost something special. However, in the Ballad of Gay Tony expansion, the game began to reclaim some of its wackiness.
Number 3.
Vice City did a great job of recapturing the 80s with music, cars and personalities. Faced with the daunting task of improving upon GTA 3, Vice City could easily have been a disappointing cash-in. However, Rockstar actually managed to improve upon the greatly revered GTA 3 by refining the gameplay, offering new open world experiences, and giving the protagonist his own voice. Although Vice City was a great game in its own right, the 80s setting certainly gave it an edge in the eyes of many players.
Number 2.
For its time, San Andreas was nothing short of a technical feat. I still struggle to accept that an open world so large could possibly exist on the PlayStation 2, but hey, Rockstar managed it. San Andreas' major draw came from its overwhelming number of distractions. Even after sinking 100 hours into the game, I still haven't done and seen everything. Interestingly enough, there were even some RPG elements, where certain stats would increase the more you train them. For example, going to the gym would increase strength.
It's number 1.
Isn't it great when a game with a ridiculous amount of hype actually lives up to it? Not only is GTA 5 the most refined in the series, but it also brought with it a lot of new features. The multiplayer has a lot more to do in it than GTA 4, the single player features 3 playable characters, and you can even go exploring underwater in a submarine. There are a few features missing that were in San Andreas, but overall the game just feels a lot more cohesive and better put together. Those are my top 5 Grand Theft Auto games. Be sure to let me know what your favourite GTA games are in the comments below. As always people, thanks very much for watching and see you next time.